All right, Shannon Dale here with Yannick Williams from the Ministry of Youth Information and Education. I did directly put it that way because I'm speaking to her on the matter of youth development. And we're talking with her because she is the youth development specialist in the Ministry of Youth. Talk to me, Yannick, the matter of the marching band and a dance training program. What exactly is it?
How are you doing, Shannon?
Not bad.
All is well? We would have been engaging a series of marching bands since last year, 2018, under the USAID Ministry Partnership for Improved Safety and Security in Schools, because mm-hmm. we continue to see marching bands as a protective factor for young persons. Mm-hmm. And so last year we did a series of consultations. You know, we tried to ascertain exactly what some of the issues were, how we could better resource some of these marching bands. And we understand that maybe resource mobilization was mm-hmm. one of those areas that they needed to be strengthened in. And so we would have done a series of training last year. We trained in resource mobilization, conflict resolution, mm-hmm. interpersonal skills, Child Care and Protection Act, and then further on later in the year last year, we also engaged marching bands in a marching bands exposition. Because, yes, usually we have our competition, but we wanted to bring them together, mm-hmm. you know, in the name of peace, love, and unity. And that was well executed in November on the said project. Now, earlier this year, January to mm-hmm. be exact, we engage marching bands, about 25 marching bands mm. in a series of training in music and dance. Mm-hmm. The music training, the end objective was to certify some persons in the Associated Board of Royal Music Examinations, grade one.
Mm. And this certification was under who? Was it under the ministry?
It was funded by the USAID project, but it was really executed under the Associated Board, certified Associated Board of School of Music, Associated Board of the Royal School of Music.
Got you.
So that would have been the end objective. We engaged 25 marching bands for music, 25 for dance, and we had a total of we engaged 30 participants, 30 music, 30 dance, and out of the 30, 15 participants successfully sat the examination. We have an 86% awesome. Pass rate.
Mm.
And set for dance, we trained about 30 persons there. We did some choreography, you know, strengthening coordination skills, and that went well as well. So we're having the official closing ceremony of the first phase of this training.
And the official closing ceremony will see the 86%
receiving certificates, and also we'll be distributing the certificates of the Royal School of Music certificates as well.
Awesome. So what now after this? So it
what
has
we're
happened.
Doing, as I mentioned before, this would have been the first phase mm-hmm. of training, and we basically just try to engage the band centered around St. Catherine, Kingston, Portland, St. Thomas. So we're moving over to the West to train, you know, and to basically deliver similar training to those bands there as well. And mm-hmm. We're trying to see if we can solicit more support in the same breath from other partnering entities so we can further, you know, develop and kind of make a more fulsome training mm-hmm. for other bands. And kind of try to see, we want to move in the direction of having something more continuous for them in mm-hmm. terms of sustainability.
And will USAID continue to be a sponsor
well,
of the project?
Well, this year, USAID will not be executing through the Ministry of Education, Youth and Information, unfortunately. But we're hoping to look into other arrangements with mm-hmm. other co-funders and donors going forward.
And so it's open to private entities
coming
on board?
It is open. We're still trying to solicit support where we can.
And finally, how can persons who want to say, you know, they want to get involved with this, how do they do it?
Well, basically what I would have developed last year was a database. Mm-hmm. I think I have to put it out there as well that formerly the Youth and Adolescents Policy Division did not really take responsibility of marching bands because we do not really have the technical resources in-house mm-hmm. to say, you know, fully service our marching bands. But what we try to do is to aid in the process of trying to build their capacity. Mm-hmm. And so what we have going now is a database, but we're trying to see if we can build on that and maybe in the future try to find a home for the marching band, so to speak. But whatever resources we can really, like, you know, contribute in that regard, and we're doing that, and we hope to do that and continue as we continue to see it as a protective factor for young persons.
All right, well, there we go. Thanks very much, Yannick Williams, who is a youth development specialist, program specialist in the Ministry of Youth. Thanks again.
Thanks, Ray.